today. We are on week three of our How to Give English Presentations. I received feedback from the students of the previous 2 weeks, and they told me that I speak too fast. My English speaking is too rapid for comprehension. So I will try to speak slower today. I want to thank you all for coming or for watching at 11 o'clock. Today in the English department, we are hosting an international conference. And so I needed to be here earlier today, and we need to finish a little earlier today as well. We will need to finish a little bit earlier, maybe around 12:15 or 12:20. We will finish, and then I will need to go, and after teaching you how to make and how to give a presentation, I need to go and actually give a presentation on my research. So I need to walk the walk, as people say. Is all English okay for my students in the room? Is English okay?
What does walk the walk mean?
Walk the walk means I can't just talk. I need to actually do it. See, so I'm telling you now about giving presentations. Later, I need to actually do it. I need to follow my own advice. Okay. So I don't recognize most of you. So you are, who's here for the first time? Oh, okay. So most of you are here for the first time. Okay, that comes with the territory that happens. And so I'd like to briefly recount what we have talked about. So for the students who are watching online, you don't have to listen to this if you have already listened to it before. Okay, I need to balance the needs of the room and online. So I want to briefly talk about some of the things we've covered over the past 2 weeks. And today we will focus on rehearsing. How do you rehearse for a presentation? So the first week, week one, we talked about public speaking in general and giving presentations. So we talked about what is public speaking. Our conclusion is public speaking at its most basic function is communication. You need to be able to communicate your message as a public speaker to the people in the room or online or in the future, right? So I'm communicating from the past to the future, okay? So it doesn't matter whether you are on the same time and space continuum, it doesn't really matter that much. The point is you can effectively communicate. Now, one of the things a public speaker wants to achieve is that everyone in the room understands everything I'm saying, is interested and focused all the time, and there are no lapses, okay? But that's impossible. One of the first things a public speaker needs to realize is that some things you say will fly over your audience, okay? You will not get everyone all the time. You will get some people most of the time. You will get no people some of the time, maybe, different levels, right? But you will never have everyone all the time. That's impossible. And so, as a public speaker, you need to let that go. You need to, let it go. Let it go, right? And you will feel a little bit less stressed. And that's the second thing. Public speaking is very stressful. Because you need to hold the attention of your audience, right? It's a very stressful thing. And people who say they love public speaking, I don't really believe them. Okay? There are maybe a specific form of public speaking that they are comfortable with, but everyone starts off in a position that is a little awkward. You are in a position to be judged, right? You have to hold the attention, and you need to be judged. Yeah, you need to present yourself and be vulnerable. And so one of the things that we will talk about in coming weeks is how to give feedback, how to present, how to receive, and how do you deal with difficult situations. But the first thing here that I want to talk about in terms of the mindset of public speaking is that you will not satisfy everyone, so don't try. It is natural to be nervous. And that is an important component that we will talk about today when it comes to rehearsal. How do you practice to the point? How do you practice until you are better? Okay, you don't feel so nervous, you feel less stressed. One of the things we also talked about in terms of improving your public speaking is you should have a model. Listen to different people deliver different kinds of lectures. Public speaking is not one size fits all. Okay, this is not like this. Public speaking is a set of skills. It's all kinds of different skills put together. So you need to find models that you like very much. Okay, personally, I really appreciate speakers like Barack Obama, Steve Jobs, and my professors from my English department, clinical psychology department. Many of them are very good at giving lectures, and you learn from your models. So something that I remind students is to have a model in mind. Okay, have someone or some people that you really admire and copy their style, duplicate their style to the best of your abilities, and then you will develop your own personal style. Okay, those are very general, those are general ideas, but for those of you who have not been here, that's the first foundation that I want to lay down. Okay, those are the first ground rules. Are there any questions in the room or online? If you are watching, you can also ask a question. Type a comment. Yeah. This feels better, I think, you know, if you are right there. You don't have to turn, yeah. It's better this way. 有没有问题? 中文英文都可以. I don't fight. But you will be recorded in the live broadcast, so that's kind of stressful. Yeah. Anyone so far? No? Okay then, we will move on now to talk about our second week. That was the first week in general, the big things we talked about. And over the course of these weeks, I'd like to focus on a few things. We have 5 weeks to cover this topic. So the first week is introduction to public speaking. Last week we talked about how to write a presentation. How do you create a presentation from nothing? And I'll go over those details in a minute. Today we will talk about how to rehearse. And rehearsal and preparation, how do you prepare for the different kinds of problems that you will face in giving the presentation? How can you be best prepared physically, mentally, for your presentation? Okay, that is what we'll talk about today. Okay? And we will have 2 more weeks. Next week we will have a holiday. I will be away. So next 2 weeks, what we will focus on, visual aids. We will talk about how to create good visual aids. They are not necessary, not all of the time. It's good to have them, but how do you create good visual aids? That will be 2 weeks from now. And 3 weeks from now, we will talk about giving and receiving feedback. Okay, so that's what we'll cover over the next 5 weeks. Introduction to public speaking, how to create a presentation, how to rehearse, how to create visual aids, and how to give and receive feedback. Okay? So just so you know, that is our strategy. Okay, that is our game plan for this very short course. We don't have a lot of time, so a lot of ground to cover. We talked about the process of creating a presentation. And I want to sort of remind you all of the big steps that we talked about. The first thing you have to know about creating a presentation is that a presentation is very, very similar to a piece of writing. Okay, it's very similar to a piece of writing. A presentation is a piece of writing for the purposes of our discussion. You treat the creation of a presentation with the same kind of mindset, with the same kind of process as writing. So if you have taken English writing courses, anyone take English writing? 英文作文？你们学过英文作文？ No? Okay, so I spent some time criticizing the lack of English writing training in Taiwan. It's terrible, right? We basically don't teach students English writing. It's not good. But I want to go through the basics, okay? English writing follows certain conventions. There are some things that you do in English writing that are different from Chinese writing. And by the way, 我们也不太教国文作文，其实在台湾我们其实也不太教，这是一个非常非常不好的一件事情。And the reason for this, I think, is because it's not easy to teach. Okay, it's not easy to teach. It's not easy to learn. It's even harder to assess. 什么叫做一篇好的作文，对不对？就是不容易，所以不好教，不好学，也不好评量。所以在基本上在台湾就不教。Okay, 基本上我们有好的作文老师非常的少，如果有的话，是非常特殊的例子。绝大部分在台湾我们的中学的语文教学里面不谈写作，不谈作文。可是我要给大家的观念是，简报跟写作是非常类似的事情。如何做简报，其实反映成你是如何思考，然后如何写作的。这个是一个非常，这个方法上面非常非常一致。You cannot be a good public speaker, you can't be a good presenter without being a good writer. That's impossible. Maybe you have writers to help you, but most of the time that's not the case. Most of the time you have to do the writing, right? You have to do the writing. And so there are some processes that we go through. Okay, and what are the big steps? Okay, I will relay them for you. First,You need to know your topic. It's very easy, right? 这个非常简单。你一定会得到一个这个简报或者是课堂报告等等的需求 right? You need to be aware of what you need to do, right? You need to receive the task. 也跟写作一样 okay? 简报一样就从 start from the task. Okay? And the task will include a few things. The topic, of course. But more importantly, it determines your audience.And how long it will be. Okay? Your audience, who your audience is, who your audience will be, and how long the presentation should be. Right? Those are the first things, those are the first parameters you need to set. Okay? 时间长短然后主题你的观众是谁 If you were teachers, I would say something different. Right? If you were teachers,If you are 幼稚园小朋友 okay, I would do something different, right? It depends on your audience. All right, that's the easy part. Once you set the time frame, the process is writing. You brainstorm. You let everything out onto the page. You spill everything out onto your page by hand or by typing. It doesn't matter. You need to let your creativity go first. Okay, you brainstorm.After you brainstorm, you can start to organize and cluster your ideas. You organize, you cluster, and then you think about how to structure it so that it is okay. And then you draft, you start drafting, you write it out. Now remember, a very important distinction between drafting in a presentation and drafting in writing is that you must practice talking.这是一件非常关键的一件事情。我听过太多太多学生的简报呢，他们觉得做简报就是把 PPT 做完，就叫做完简报了。有没这样的经验？我明天要报告，所以我今天开始做 PPT， 在图书馆里面非常安静的做 PPT， 做完的话，我明天的简报做完了，我就回家睡觉。你第一次讲是你在台上讲，这样不叫有练习，这样不叫做完。You know what I mean?You need to practice giving the presentation. That's the process of drafting. Okay, 你不见得要打逐字稿，可是你要练习讲过一次，也是今天我们这个 rehearsal 的一个非常大、非常非常重要的一个原则。所以，当你在制作 PPT 的过程当中，制作投影片的过程当中 ，Okay, 我再次呼吁大家，你边做就要边练习 讲一次 ，OK， 边做边讲，你会发现这个地方这样讲不清楚，把它改掉。有没有听过？你们看过太多的老师，很多老师也是这样啊，对不对？他们报告就是把 PPT 上面字全部念一次，对不对？有没有做 ？Have you had those classes before？ Yeah， 有没有这样的老师？有没有听过 PPT 这样就哇哇哇哇，这样念完了就讲完了。对 ，That's not giving a presentation. That's reading the slides. OK， 朗读吗？不是朗读，简报不是朗读比赛。OK， so 练习 ，practice. All right， those of you who are watching in the future, if I can leave you with one bit of advice, one, practice talking through your slides as you are making them. OK， as you are making. OK。That's a big guideline in rehearsal. That's a big guideline in rehearsal as well. And so this is what you do. Okay, you draft everything, you practice delivering, and then you edit and edit and edit. You edit and depending on how important the presentation is. If the presentation is a make or break case with your client, right? 每一个大老板叫你做简报。这是一个一千万的案子 ，then edit the hell out of it, okay? Five times, six times, seven times, keep practicing. Okay, 如果只是课堂报告 ，okay, 老师不太管你等等，那随便嘛，对不对？哈 ，you but depends on how important it is, right? 那这个时间成本，任何的这种作品都是这样子，是时间成本。So the point is edit and edit and edit.We say often in writing, you draft with the door closed. That means you do it yourself, right? You don't seek advice from others. You don't write with other people. You draft with the door closed. Your thoughts, your ideas, your writing, but you edit with the door open. Send it to your friends. Practice in front of your friends. And they will give you good advice, hopefully, if they're good friends. They will give you good advice. Find someone you trust,to give you some good advice. That is the best, that is what I can tell you, is the best thing you should know about rehearsal. Other things are just tips and tricks, but this is the biggest thing you need to know. Edit and edit and edit and rehearse. So here we are, rehearsal. Now you have completed your presentation, you have all your slides, they are set, you have basically completed everything.But you are still open to editing, okay? 所以现在往下讲的呢，全部都是，已经投影片都做完了 ，okay? 已经大纲也都列完了 ，okay? 大概都修的差不多了，那现在进入比较密集的练习的阶段 ，okay? 这是我们的今天主要要花的时间。前面到目前为止有没有问题 ？No, anyone online? 有没有在看呢、啊？有人在看吗？有。Oh, 九个人在看 Oh my gosh, thank you, nine people are watching. Oh, wonderful. 再一个人先拿手机出来，再一个我就敬畏了，你看我就敬畏了啊。OK, 开玩笑的，好，谢谢大家的收看。OK, thank you all very much. So we're talking about rehearsals today. A little stuffy in this room, but that's okay. Rehearsals. Now, I find this part very exciting.A rehearsal is a very exciting process, and you have to think about it in terms of it as a performance. Okay, 演讲顾名思义就是要演一点，对不对？不能只讲而已，你不能只演，对不对？就是要演也要讲嘛，所以演讲就是这样。简报也是一样的意思，就是你不能只是报告而已，对，就是你要稍微就是有演讲的一些特质在里面。Okay, so what are some things you do in rehearsal?Let me ask you all, 有谁简报会先练习的？目前为止，有没有简报会练习的？各位 ，you practice, right? Okay, wonderful. So, how many times do you practice?
Every time,
like for every, no, no, I mean like for one presentation,、yeah. how many times do you go through it? Wow. Okay, that's good. That's good. Depending on the time. Okay, so 如果你从来没有练习过的话 do it. All right, do it. Follow my advice. 我们今天这样讲讲讲讲讲讲讲，如果你不做的话，等于没有讲。OK， 如果要讲完了，你学到哦，很好很好，你跟你不执行 ，it doesn't help。OK， 你下次还是把电脑打开来，把 PPT 全部做完，你就觉得自己的简报完成了。It doesn't help. OK， it doesn't help. So when it comes to rehearsal, the first thing, like I said, it's about performance. It is about performance. And so when you are performing, you have to understand something. The first thing is,the less you leave to chance, the better. Okay, every time you perform, this is like, 我常比喻哈，就是像在做菜一样，就像在做菜，你每次都要重新做一次，对不对？不能说你做完就放在那里。做简报的历程就像在做菜，你每一次做都是从原料重新做一次，做成成品，了解吗？从第一片讲到最后一片，就是从备料开始做到结尾，从头到尾步骤做一次。了解吗？这个比喻要了解，也就是说，不是说投影片做完，你把料背完，不代表你能够把料再做出来。这个比喻可以吗？不代表你有办法按照步骤非常正确的看到，就是把成品做出来。那简报有各式各样，像菜有各式各样的嘛，对不对？好，你可以，你非常简单，如果你只炒饭而已，不是炒蛋，哎，比较不会错嘛，对不对？啊，可是如果你要做的是非常复杂的一道菜，那你就要练习。好，所以呢？The less you leave to chance, the better. Okay, 也就是说，不要把自己的简报的命运丢到命运的手里，机会，因为现场的状况一定会改变，一定会有各式各样的问题。万一电脑不行的话怎么办？万一电脑不行的时候怎么办 ？PPT 秀不出来的时候怎么办 ？What do you do? Okay.所以呢，准备的第一件事情是去除掉这些问题，把硬体准备好，先把硬体准备好。所以呢，不管我再怎么样，就是我已经，就是我等一下，我例如等一下，我一定有两台机器，我一定有两台机器，就我自己一定带着电脑，因为我要剪报嘛，我一定带着，我会带着线。如果投影机出问题 ，there's nothing I can do， 对不对？就说你要就是要向命运低头，没有错。在可以的范围之内，一定要面面俱到的准备，把线准备好，把影片把投影片准备好，把电脑准备好，对，然后最好把投影片印出来。万一真的不行的时候，就是就做 ，It's OK。重点是讲者，重点不是投影片，重点是讲者。所以你准备好，你比较不会紧张。所以这是准备的第一个步骤 ，Don't leave things to chance。Okay, when it comes to this sort of thing. And don't leave things to chance in terms of your delivery either. Okay? So the second suggestion that I will give when it comes to rehearsal is to go there and try it out. 例如说你下个礼拜要报告，假设你下礼拜要报告，或是你要去某个地方报告，最好是提早或者是前一天先去测一次仪器。你不一定要完全一模一样。你要去模拟那个情境，就是我们要模拟考嘛，为什么有高中？为什么叫模拟考？就是模拟真实的状况，所以叫模拟考，对不对 ？So when you are there， 听起来很简单，可是很多同学不这样做，你知道吗？就插了随身碟，发现没有档案的，或者是就是在最后拼拼凑凑档案不见了，被删掉某一些片段等等，各式各样的问题。Okay， don't leave those things to chance. Okay， keep it in your control beforehand.Okay, so prep everything beforehand, and then when you are there, arrive early, test out the equipment, you will feel less nervous. You will feel less nervous. 大部分的大学生哈，面对第一次要面对简报，而且有可能是英文的时候，是大学毕业的时候，找第一份工作，然后你要面试。面试毋庸置疑是一种公开的public speaking, it's a form 公开演讲的东西。也许你不用对很多人讲。可是你是呈现你的公开的这一面，对不对？你的 your professional side。那在面试的时候，你当然要把什么东西都准备好啊，多印几份履历表，多练习几次，先知道你要去的地方在哪里，等等，对不对？所以我们才会说先去看考场，等等之类一样的原则，可以吗？先可以吗？大家不理我，可以吗？可以吗？
可以可以
啊，可以哈，大家不理我 ，OK 。可以哈，所以 prepare first. Be prepared. And that is the first thing that I can give you. Prep the physical part and prep your files, the software. Make sure that it's all prepared. And sometimes problems will happen, and that's okay. The second thing that I will say in terms of rehearsal is to find someone to help you. Okay, find someone to help you. 例如说，如果你要去面试的话，那就去模拟面试。Okay, 找一个你信任的人，让自己放在那个位置上。Okay, 例如说你要简报的话，那就是先讲一次给同学听，给老师。It's a very easy idea, right? 这个观念其实非常简单，可是很多学生不做。老师自己我也不可能每次都做到，对，就是越重要越要这样子做，可以吗？好 ，So how do you start？ Okay, 我给大家我自己的例子， okay, 这是最有效的方法。我自己在简报过程当中，大概广义的来讲分成几种哈。我在中学到大学的时候被邀请参加演讲比赛。Okay, 那年纪越大，这个演讲比赛会我觉得越来越自然，所以我其实国小我没有那么喜欢，但是中学慢慢的你可以有一些自己的风格，然后有一些自己的想法，而不是那么样的知识。那可是呢，我第一个我学到的事情，这种练习的时候，其实是学琴的时候，我父母亲要求我要学钢琴。那最好的事情就是你能够先做自己的judge。做自己的评委，做自己的监督者。所以当你要简报的时候，看着镜子，当你要简报的时候 look in the mirror， 你在看着镜子的时候，你就会发现自己的一些状态，你会发现一些自己的奇怪的一些事情。对，我自己也是后来就是看那些影片的时候，慢慢发现自己会有了一些特质。那有些就让他就在那里 go 了。That's personal style. But you will notice some things in the mirror that you did not realize before. Okay, so when you are practicing, if you're not sure, you know, use a mirror or use a camera, okay, to record yourself. That's even better. But mirror first, because I think camera is a little bit more stressful.Okay, so first thing I suggest is to use a mirror. You will find problems with your body language. Okay, you will slouch. You will find problems with your appearance. Okay, you will find problems with your delivery. Maybe you don't smile as much as you think. 我们对于我们想象的样子跟实际上别人看到的样子是不太一样的。那你要让它越来越接近。Then you don't leave things up to chance, right? 你要越了解别人看到的状况是什么，大家清楚吗？了解好。So practice first in the mirror. Okay, practice first in the mirror. And I do this twice. Okay, I do this twice. I practice by looking in the mirror. 念顺一点，把事情该做的念顺。那因为演讲也是要背稿子，那如果是要简报或者讲课的话，那比较不需要这样报告啊，讲课不需要背稿子，讲错没有关系嘛，对不对？就重来，或者是有一点 lapse 没有关系。背稿子你要很硬的去背，那其他的这个很罕见，在真实的人生里面，背稿子的机会是非常少，顶多你背自我介绍而已，对不对？这个世界上有什么状况下是你需要背着稿子的 ？No, right？ 没有吧？你可能要背一下自己的自我介绍，在简介的时候，你要习惯讲一些事，可是几乎不会。就是你要讲整段的时候需要背稿。So, look in the mirror, use your notes, and then second time, film yourself, or have someone film you. Okay? Film yourself and have someone film you. Let's take a break. Okay? 5 to 10 minutes. After you finish filming your, you drink.